Hello and welcome to What's New on Netflix, the weekly show where we round up the best new arrivals on Netflix so you don't have to. Here's what to stick on your watch list from Friday the 19th of June. First up, the floor is lava. Ah, everyone jump on the sofa and grow up. The floor isn't really lava in this hilarious new game show. It's just water that's turned red with the blood of dead contestants. I'm kidding, it's probably just food colouring. Which does mean you definitely don't want to fall in, as that stuff is sticky. The Floor is Lava is essentially the Crystal Maze by way of Total Wipeout, a conveyor belt of hapless adults trying to make it through an obstacle course and, more often than not, failing for your viewing pleasure. Before you watch it on Netflix later today, however, a word of caution.
Don't try it at home, though. Please don't try it.
Don't try it at home.
Don't try this at home, bro. You're gonna have
kids. If you can get some lava in your house,
no,
try it.
Don't.
Next up, we've got The Sinner Series 3 and a brand new case for Detective Harry Ambrose to solve. This one seems innocuous at first. A fatal car accident resulting in both the tragic death of one Nick Haas and the, suspiciously injury-free survival of, what was his name again?
Jamie Burns.
So, Jamie, can you tell us how Nick was killed and how all you've got is a tiny little scrape on your forehead? Didn't think so. Right then, Harry, I've cracked him. You take it from here. Should be easy enough. Although there are 8 episodes of The Sinner Season 3, so I'm guessing you've got a few twists and turns to get through first. I'm sure you'll manage, though. And you can enjoy watching Detective Ambrose do just that when The Sinner Season 3 arrives on Netflix on the 19th of June. Next, we've got The Politician Series 2, where ambitious young statesman Peyton Hobart has graduated from running for student body president and is now after a seat in the actual New York State Senate. This means he'll need to oust Majority Leader Dee Dee Standish and her rambunctious head of staff, Hadassah Gold, played with delightful exuberance by Bette Midler.
Do you know anything about spicy lube? I need you to go get me some.
No, I can't say I do know anything about spicy lube, although I imagine it's...
spicy!
Look, is this what being in politics is like? Because I think I picked the wrong career. The Politician Series 2 is funny, sharp, full of barbarous put-downs.
It underlines the need for a new generation of young leaders who, forgive me, aren't going to be dead in 20 years.
I mean, ouch. And you can watch it all on Netflix from today. Okay, so you can watch Bridge of Spies on Netflix this week, a film directed by Steven Spielberg, written by the Coen brothers, and starring Tom Hanks, a creative coalition who could probably re-sync the Titanic with the combined weight of all the Oscars they've won. But here is my very important question. Why do people in movies take so long to answer the flipping phone? Get on with it! Honestly, this does my head in every time. What if it's an emergency? What if you're in a film set in 1957 during the height of the Cold War and Tom Hanks has phoned you because he needs to negotiate the exchange of 2 spies in East Berlin? That's the basic plot of Bridge of Spies I've just outlined for you there, by the way. It's really very good, and if you haven't seen it yet, you definitely should when it arrives on Netflix on the 20th of June. And finally, look, I get Christmas is probably the last thing you want to hear about right now, but Krampus is coming to Netflix this week, and there are some things you should know. 1, he sees you when you're sleeping. 2, he knows when you're awake. And most importantly, 3, he's an evil anti-Santa who leaps from rooftop to rooftop delivering horror to all the boys and girls who've been naughty, so be good for goodness sake. No, that's not how I remember the song going either, but I also don't remember being locked in a house and attacked by an evil Christmas demon from Austro-Bavarian folklore just because I shouted, "I hate Christmas!" at my family.
I hate Christmas!
And I should know. It's something I do every year. Anyway, everything soon goes very wrong indeed, as the family is besieged by murderous gingerbread, killer teddy bears, and whatever the heck that thing is. Krampus arrives on Netflix on the 25th of June. What will you be watching first? Let us know in the comments, give us a like if you found this video helpful, and remember to join us again next Friday for another rundown of what's new on Netflix.